You've just asked the question on everyone's lips in Washington and beyond right now, Annette. What kind of impeachment trial are Americans and the rest of the world going to see when the proceedings begin in earnest next Tuesday? It is an outstanding question because, look, what all we've been saying all along is there's little doubt and little drama and suspense over the ultimate verdict here, that Donald Trump, by a Senate that is controlled by Republicans, is going to be very likely acquitted, almost certainly acquitted, and it will be grounds for him to say he has been exonerated. Here's the fact of the matter is, yesterday, those senators did swear an oath to do impartial justice, to be impartial. Yet the fact of the matter is, on both sides, this has been hyper-partisan. The Democrats, for their part, say that the slew of testimony from Foreign Service officials, from national security officials during weeks of House testimony provide devastating, if not absolutely damning evidence of Trump's abuse of power and subsequent obstruction of Congress. Their minds are made up ahead of this trial, as are, on the other side of the aisle, the Republicans' minds being made up equally, seeing this trial echoing Donald Trump's line that this trial was a partisan witch hunt by a Democratic Party bent on taking down a president that they never thought deserved to be elected. So this is a vendetta trial. With that hyper-partisan divide, the question remains, will witnesses be called? Now, a trial, technically, you could argue, doesn't have to have witnesses. But the fact of the matter is, in the previous cases of impeachments in the Senate with Nixon, with Clinton, while Nixon resigned first, you had, A, most of the evidence was already known by the time this came to trial. And what's remarkable here is that minds have been made up on both sides while new revelations are emerging. You have an associate of Giuliani, Trump's personal lawyer, basically saying Trump knew everything that was going on in the past days in interviews on TV and in newspapers. And you have the Government Accountability Office, a government body, basically saying that Trump violated the law when he suspended the security aid to Ukraine. Damning revelations coming out. Will they be taken into account?
Even with a trial with no witnesses or minimal witnesses, how is this going to impact Donald Trump in an election year?
The hardcore Donald Trump supporters and the hardcore line, and remember, this has become the party of Trump. The Republicans who are sitting in judgment in this basically have embraced and espoused Donald Trump's line, like I just said, that this is a partisan witch hunt, that this is a sham trial under false pretenses and phony vendetta-like motivations. However, the fact of the matter is, Trump can say whatever he wants, and the trial itself, and in fact, if there are witnesses who could provide perhaps even further damning testimony, especially if John Bolton, a former national security advisor, who has indicated he would offer testimony if subpoenaed, if they were to come forward, plus other potential witnesses, it would definitely be a stain, a stigma on Donald Trump's legacy. And you could say what you want, but Donald Trump, we know from his past, is a man who very much cares about his self-image. He's self-centered, and he has been called a narcissist, perhaps not without perhaps with good reason. So he is going to be closely watching, even if he acts as if he doesn't care about this trial, even if he acts as if this trial is a sham and a witch hunt, and that Americans should keep walking, you know, don't even bother to give this any notice. How Americans will respond is also something, because this testimony, if there are witnesses at this trial, Donald Trump's hardcore supporters are unlikely to abandon him no matter what happens at this trial. They've already made up their minds that this is a partisan witch hunt, as the Donald Trump and his associates say. But for swing voters who are an important part of the electorate, and they could be anywhere from 25% to 30% or more, they could be looking at this and say, especially if the Republicans don't call witnesses, say, you know what? He may be innocent, but if he's so innocent and he believes he should be exonerated, why not call those witnesses to prove his case that he is innocent, as he says? So Donald Trump can says what he wants, but this is going to definitely impact the shape and the tenor of the election going into 2020.